What is metallurgy? Means isolation or extraction of metals from their natural sources is called as metallurgy. Means for isolation or extraction of metals chemically and commercially, these are naturally available from the ores of such metals. That means to isolate our desired metal, we have to get ore of that metal. Isolation process of metals or elements from their ores consists of three steps as in the previous class. So what is the first step is concentration of ore. Second step is isolation of metal from that concentrated ore. Third step is purification of isolated metal. So these three steps included in metallurgy, which can offer a pure metal after these three processes. Come to the first step, concentration of ore. Remember, most of these minerals and ores are available in the earth's crust by the addition of some impurities, with the formation or by the addition of some impurities. Those impurities which may be connected with ores or minerals are called as gangue. So we have to eliminate this gangue present with ore. The elimination of gangue from ore is called as concentration. It is also called as dressing, are also called as benefaction. So before we are going to concentrate the ore, the lumps of the ore are breakdown and it is converted into a powder form. So from this powder form of ore, or by taking this powder form of ore, we have to concentrate that ore by eliminating gangue. What is gangue here? The impurities which may be present in addition to ore or by combining with ore is called as gangue. The elimination process of gangue from the ore is considered as concentration or dressing or benefaction. Here, the concentration of ore consists of several steps. The selection of these steps for the concentration of ore depends upon the nature of the metal compound and also the nature of gangue present with that ore. And also, the selected steps depends upon nature of metal of the compound, that is mineral or ore, and of gangue. And also, the selection steps for concentration of ore also depends upon environmental factors and availability of instruments and nature of metal. So variety of steps available to concentrate desired ore. So that out of the available steps, which steps are useful for us. For specified ore, it depends upon nature of metal of the compound and also nature of gang present with that ore. And also, the selection of steps for the concentration of ore also depends upon environmental factors, availability of instruments and nature of metals. Some of the most important two methods used by us for concentration of ore, or some of the methods are used to concentrate ore, they are hydraulic lifting or levigation. We can call it as hydraulic lifting or hydraulic washing. Come to this. In hydraulic washing, or by using this method of concentration of ore, that means it is a process to concentrate our ore. In this process, actually it is used if ore and gang, ore and gang will have different gravities. That means the gang which may be present as contamination with ore, the difference in gravities of ore and gang is very well, then hydraulic washing or levigation process is much important or useful to concentrate our ore. In this process, a stream of upper water or running water is allowed to pass through powder of ore which consists of gang. That means a stream of running water is allowed onto ore with gang. During this process, less gravity gang will left with water, whereas more gravity ore will reaches behind. That means it seems to be elimination of less gravity gang from ore. It is a type of gravity separation. It is a type of gravity separation. The more dense ore will be collected at the bottom, whereas the less dense or less gravity gang will be eliminated through running water. So this type of concentration of ore is called as hydraulic washing or levigation. The second method used by us is magnetic separation. Here, in this method, some of the ores which consist of magnetic character, or those ores which can attracted by magnets, are separated by using this magnetic separation method. So here there is a conveyor present or belt present here. This is a magnetic wheel through which we are going to connect. It is connected with a conveyor belt. Onto this conveyor belt, we are going to pour ore plus gang. That means impure ore. So while the ore will pass through this conveyor belt, the magnetically attractive ore particles, especially the iron particles, will be collected here. in this. Because of magnetic behavior of second ore, it is going to attract the magnetically active chemical substances present in ore and it will be collected here. Whereas non-magnetic particles will be collected in another area. These are non-magnetic particles, whereas these are magnetic particles. This magnetic separation is much useful in case of iron ores, because iron will easily attracted by magnet. Hence, for the separation or for the concentration of iron ores, the best method is magnetic separation. And next method is froth flotation. Method froth flotation method. So one more method available to concentrate ores is froth flotation method. Especially this method is much useful in case of, it is used in case of sulfide ores. Sulfide ores. That means the impurities present in sulfide ores will be eliminated, or the gunk present in sulfide ores will be eliminated by froth flotation method. Here in this froth flotation method, the powdered ore is mixed with water in a basin to which a pedal is fixed. So what will be expected? One, I would like to consider this is an instrumental setup. Here we are going to arrange so from where we are going to apply air or water or oil from this area. So come to this. Those of sulfide ores first placed in this now this basin or arrangement or instrument, we are going to apply some air or water from this area. So this is the pedal. So by using this pedal, while we are going to stir it, then the powdered ore can converts into slurry. Okay, by using or by adding water to powdered ore, especially those of sulfide ores, by stirring it with a pedal arranged like this, it is going to convert our powder ore with water into a slurry. So to this we are going to add some oil. So upon addition of oil, some froth is going to develop like this. The froth will be developed at the top of, so just it seems to be dilution of curd by using a curd churner. So at this, while we are going to stir that pedal speedily by adding some amount of water, so it is going to produce some froth. And this froth, due to presence of oil, it is going to, that means froth will going to catch minerals, whereas gangue will left in water. So this is, this method of separation is called as froth flotation method. Here, to maintain froth and to get stable froth, we have to add some stabilizers during the process of froth flotation method. For the concentration of ore, we have to add some stabilizers like cresol, aniline, and also some of the chemical substances like fats, pigments are used to maintain that froth. So the formed froth can eliminate, or the formed froth will bring the minerals present in powdered ore, where gang will left in the water only. So this is froth flotation method. But specially in case of, if any single ore consists of two different type of sulfides, for example, I would like to consider zinc sulfide and lead sulfide. I would like to take an ore for the separation of lead metal, but in addition to lead sulfide, it also consists of one more sulfide, that is zinc sulfide. In this case, with lead sulfide, the zinc sulfide is called as gang. So to eliminate or to isolate lead from this sulfide ore, first we have to eliminate zinc sulfide. In such process, the mixture of sulfide ores, to this mixture of sulfide ores, we have to add sodium cyanide. Upon addition of sodium cyanide, the sodium cyanide is going to react with zinc sulfide and forms sodium zinc cyanide complex. Sodium zinc cyanide complex, where the lead sulfide will become free. The free lead sulfide will be separated out from the ore. So this is the first step included in the metallurgy, that is concentration of ore. So once again, elimination of gang, that is impurities from the ore, is called as concentration or dressing or benefaction. Here it completed in most important three steps. First one is hydraulic washing, which is also called as levigation. Second one is magnetic concept, and third one is froth flotation method.